you're using your brain, you're thinking all the time. You're thinking about how you can do a good deed every day. You actually have to think about that or you won't do it. And on the battlefield, very, very young Marines, many of them, the majority of them in an assault unit of 160 Marines, there may be over 100 of them that are between the ages of 17 and 21. They're very, very young. And what you have to do is when you put a weapon in their hand and they're going to be representing America, they're going to be defending America, how do you keep your values foremost? How do you make certain you only employ that weapon when you must? You don't employ that weapon to hurt an innocent person on the battlefield. Think of a woman or a child. You go out of your way to avoid hurting anyone who's innocent on the battlefield because you don't want to live with that the rest of your life. That's not consistent with American values. But you have to be prepared for it. You have to go through tough training. You have to go through training where you're tired. You have to go through training when you're hot and exhausted. And you need to go through this so that when you deal with ethical decisions or tactical decisions, that you're prepared. Just like a Boy Scout, you're prepared for that. And that means you're going to have to use your head. In the Marine Corps, for example, at every rank, there are certain books you have to read. Like all new Marines have to read 4 or 5 books. And they are books where we try to pass on that you're not going to experience anything that other young men haven't gone through in their past. You're going to find in those books that other people met the same kind of challenges, and here's how they dealt with them. And then when you make corporal and sergeant, you get a new list of books. If you're a lieutenant, you make captain, here's your new list, and you start all over again reading these books. And as each rank comes up, if you make general, the first thing that happens is you get a new list of books that you have to read. You never stop learning. You're always taking those 6 inches between your ears and you're expanding your understanding, mostly of other people, of other situations, because you have got to take a full responsibility for your own development so that you are prepared when you're given a mission and you have to carry it out. We give very, very young leaders a lot of responsibility in the Marines. There are squad leaders out there in charge of a dozen other Marines who are only 20 years old. And it's based on their experience, on their training, on their self-discipline that they are prepared, as the Scout motto says. So use that brain the good Lord gave you and make certain you're always sharpening it, you're always educating yourself, you're watching other people, coaches, teachers, scout masters. You're always doing better by listening to your mom and dad. Make sure you're using that brain so you become the best person you can be. You'll never regret it.